All right, in this video, we got a little situation here. We just finishing hiking a new hiking trail. And you notice here we have our track here in teal color or light blue. But you notice here on our base map, the trail is not represented on the base map. And depending on your GPS or smartphone app, this map might use OpenStreetMap as the data. So what we can do with OpenStreetMap is we can actually go and submit trail data to the map. And eventually, a couple months down the road, when the maps get refreshed onto the devices or smartphone apps, we can have this trail represented on the map itself. So I'll show you how that works. All right, so we got the GPS track extracted from the Garmin onto Gaia GPS. I've done this in another video, but let's scroll through the map and let me just toggle the track on and off here on the overlay. And we can see here that there are a couple of segments that is not represented on the map. So here's one over here that we need to add on, so which is a new trail. And if I scroll down the map here, there's another segment that looks new. And let me toggle. So we have two segments we're going to add to this map. So like I said, OpenStreetMap is open to the community, and we're just simply going to add these two segments to the trail. And down the road, these base maps will be refreshed. So we're gonna flip over to our tracks here. And what we're gonna do is we're going to extract the GPX file. Now, this is very different based on the type of application that you're using. You may already have the GPX already on your computer, but I'm just going to quickly export the GPX here from Gaia. I'm just gonna download it here. And once I have that downloaded, I'm gonna flip over to OpenStreetMap. I'm logged in as an account, and I'm going to click on the top here on GPS traces or your GPS tracks. And I'm going to upload a trace or upload a track. And I'm going to find that GPX file that I downloaded. And I'm going to add the name and some tags. And I'm going to set the visibility to private. Now, once that is done, I'm going to upload. And given the time of day during the week, this might take a couple minutes or a half an hour for it to flip from pending to see the breadcrumb outline. And I'm just gonna refresh the browser here. And now that we have that, we're gonna click on the edit. And this brings us in the map edit mode. So now anything that we do is going to change the map. We can change any feature on this OpenStreetMap. And just for reference, we're using the ID in browser editor, which works really, really good. Again, OpenStreetMap is a community of people who are uploading and modifying the map as we go. So I'm just gonna zoom in here. I'm just gonna take a look here. You can see in purple, there's my GPS track. You can see here that there's already part of the trail already established. We can see here where the new segment spurs off from the main trail. I'm gonna click on the line here, and I'm just gonna snap a new segment from the main trail. And I'm just going to trace on top of my GPS track. So we're not really incorporating our GPS track into OpenStreetMap. Rather, when we're using the ID browser here, we're just tracing on top. And if you're using the satellite view based on your area, if you didn't have a GPS track, you can just simply trace on top of the satellite imagery. Anyway, here we're done, we're finishing. Double click, and now we have our segment created. Notice here on the left, we need to categorize what we just traced. So this is a path, and we have a bunch of different types of path. So we have that. We have a whole bunch of other metadata that we can add here on the left, but I'm just gonna add it here. And on the right, I'm gonna click on save. And of course, anytime we make a change to OpenStreetMap, we're gonna add a comment as to what we actually did. And if I wanted somebody to review my edits, I can click on the checkbox and upload, but this case, this is new, I'm just gonna upload it. And it's gonna upload the changes to street map. And once it's done, you can see underneath the purple line, the segment is in. And now I can proceed to go down to the second segment. And I'm just gonna follow my track just to make sure there's nothing too crazy here. You can see here when you're using the satellite view, it really does help you visualize to see where the map is and where your GPS track. Here in this situation, I'm using a Montana 700, but any type of GPS will work. The more important thing is to extract the GPX file into a trace, and then you can use that as a reference to trace over it. So again, we're going to click online,
find the last segment of the main trail, and then we're just going to continue this trail. Now, since I did an out and back, you can see here that the track file kind of diverges, so I'm just going to go straight up the middle right here. And I can use as few points as I need for this line, or if you really want to be detailed, you can be really close with each point as you add in here. All right, so I'm just going to finish adding a couple of points right here. And once I'm done this trail, here we go, one more, double click on the last one. I'm done. I'm going to categorize it here. It's footpath. Let me open up fields here at the bottom. You can see you can add a whole bunch of other details to categorize this. But again, we're going to save it. And we're going to add a comment as to why we did the change to the map set. And we're just simply going to upload. Now, this might take a couple of hours to refresh on the view mode or read-only mode of the map. In this view, it might take a few hours. But if you click on edit, you can see here, without our GPS track, you can see that the line is put in place. And eventually, this will get refreshed. And we might see it on our GPS or other applications such as Gaia, All Trails, Trailforks, and all that stuff. And there you go.